What's changed in the industry?
I think what's changed in primarily, and particularly when I look at Daimler and Mercedes, is that you need to focus very much on what are your core competencies, and you need to be very much, you need to have a very much aligned company behind you with the right mindset, people knowing very much what it takes for the brand to be successful in driving that forward. So dedication, I think, is very, very important. And the time spent by trying to maybe merging certain cultures into one company is tremendous and may take away some of that focus. So I think that's one of the lessons we learned, and therefore I think we also separated a part of that story a few years back from Chrysler, and since then have really focused again much more on our core business and are growing quite strongly in that now.
And Ford, you've had some very interesting experiences. How, when the recession hit, Ford and GM were in, how would we call it, a tough spot. But Ford's turned it around, and it's an incredible story.
Yeah, I mean, it was quite a roller coaster ride for the last few years, 5 years. Fortunately, Ford did not have to take any government bailouts. GM and Chrysler did, and we were able to basically set our own course. You know, not to say that it wasn't a very challenging time. We, similar to the example just given, we really got back to our core business. We sold off a lot of brands. We had a stable of a lot of luxury brands. And, you know, it's a lot of mouths to feed when you've got that many brands, that many vehicles to try and refresh and keep relevant in the marketplace. And so we did the same thing. We focused on what we're good at. We focused on our core brands and really putting, you know, the best technology possible into the Ford brand. And, you know, it's been a real success story. And if we look at the last couple of years, you know, we were, a couple of years ago, our share price was $1, which really said, you know, that as far as the market was concerned, we weren't really worth much of anything. And we ran that up to $18. It's come off a bit as the market has slumped. But, you know, so just an incredible roll to be able to go from $1 to $18. I wish I'd bought more stock at $1, but you never know, right?
Manny, that must have been fantastic for you guys.
No, it wasn't. No. We're entrepreneurs, so I must give you the side of the story from our side, and I'll talk you from a South African context point of view. And I think it's important that globalization has arrived in South Africa, and I think it's important that we go back for the younger people here. I see some people here who don't know the history of South African motor industry. Pre-1994, we had about 17 brands in South Africa and probably 7 manufacturers with about 175 model derivatives. And then we had an import duty of 115%. In 1994, with the advent of democracy, obviously belonging to WTO, we opened up our country to imports and exports. And that's come. We never exported many cars, therefore we never imported many. But the advent of 1994 changed the whole of South African scene, where today we have probably 60 manufacturers in South Africa, or brands, and we have 1,300 model derivatives. So you can see the choice that people have in this country. There'll always be what we know as the big five will probably control 60% of the market. And the 40% is left to the entrepreneurs like us to come in and give people the alternatives. And that's what we've done. So from our point of view, I think it's been fantastic from a South African consumer point of view, from a choice point of view, and the alternative that people are looking for. And it's also, I think, helped a lot in keeping prices in check. Because balancing the import to the exports, I think, has helped a lot in the South African context.
Bodo, and the BMW experience.
Yeah, you have asked about change, and I think change is normal. When we started here in 1974, and it has been mentioned, I don't know, Martin, how many brands were available in the world. I think 50 at least, maybe more. Nowadays, if I count it right, we have 14 companies left who own all the car brands. BMW is one of the only ones who, let's say, hasn't got a main group behind it. And when we started in 1974, there was nearly nothing, and you have talked about, we have started an export program in South Africa to start to export cars. And if I talk now about 50,000 units, 100,000 units, which are possible, then it's a big change compared to 1974. Nobody would have thought that this is possible. But that's part of the normal life. In 1974, even 10 years before, there was no Twitter, there was no Facebook, there was no, you name it, you know it better than me, what's all available. Yeah? And this is part of the ongoing change of what we need to do as an automotive industry, whether we are in South Africa or around the world. We need to adapt. We need to try to be a bit quicker, to anticipate what's coming, and to align our products early enough. It takes 6 years to create a product, so you must be a bit ahead and to anticipate this and to do this. So I would say those who have survived until now, they must have been somehow not so bad in anticipating the changes which are there, and with the crisis which we had, the same thing.